you know, when I was sick and when I was diagnosed, like I knew why this was happening. I knew why I was getting a divorce. It wasn't necessarily that things were just horrible. We just weren't taking care of each other anymore. I wasn't taking care of myself. He wasn't taking care of himself. I wasn't, you know, nurturing my body. I wasn't doing what mattered. And that's why I was sick. I was in autopilot. I was in this just mundane world of not doing anything. I was just showing up, getting up every morning and going to bed. And I was doing the same exact thing every single day. And nothing was fulfilling for myself, which is interesting to say because I had two kids and they were awesome. But I was doing the stereotypical mom thing every single day. And I wasn't doing it because I wanted to be doing it. I was doing it because it was what my obligation was as a mom, to be driving them to school, making their lunch, doing all of these things, where now it's like we intentionally spend time together doing the things that we love doing. So we talk, we read, we play games, we sit outside, we hold the chickens, we do these things because this is what matters to us. And it took, you know, facing some pretty crazy adversity in my life for me to stop and really realize what mattered and what matters now and how to identify when I'm going back into that same routine. And that's what's so important about scheduling it, that I always tell people, like, just start with like a small amount of time. So they say 21 days forms a habit. So start with 21 days and start with one thing, just one thing every single day for 5 to 10 minutes that you're going to do for yourself. That could be reading a couple chapters out of a book. It could be taking a bath. It could be meal planning. I love meal planning. Like, that to me is rewarding because I know that I'm going to be feeding my family something healthy and rewarding. So look at what anything that you like and put it into your calendar every single day for 21 days and never falter from it. Like, make this a non-negotiable obligation. Like, I am going to show up. This is my contract to myself to make myself healthy and happy, and do that. And pretty soon it becomes a routine. And when you start to see that change in yourself where you become really, really content and happy and aware, and you start to show up in your world in a huge way, then when you fall out of that, it's clear and you know, and it's like that. And you just snap right back into it and you're like, okay, what am I not doing? Because that's what I'm going to do again. I'm going to get back on track. I'm going to start taking care of myself. And once you get that 21-day one challenge down, pretty soon you're going to be doing 3, 4, 5 things a day. And I look at my schedule and my life, and it's like my entire day is full of self-care. And it's the thing that I think is such a misconception about self-care is that people feel like it has to be something done by yourself. But for me, self-care is spending time with my family. It's spending time with my husband. It's sitting out in the morning drinking coffee and laughing, or listening to the people riding their bikes that feel this need to have this full-blown conversation as they're panting in front of our road. And it's all of these different things that we do on a regular basis that is self-care to me. But it happens all day long. My job is self-care because I get to spend my time with people that I choose to spend my time with. These are my friends. They're my circle of influence. So I just think it's so important that people realize that when you're looking at your sweet spot, or you're trying to find the things that make you happy in your world, that it doesn't have to be something that you have to get creative with. You don't have to create. It should be something that lives in your heart, that lives in your mind, that you're just naturally doing, that just naturally brings joy to you.